Yeah. So, George, you know, at CPI, we believe that the disruptive effects AI will have on our everyday lives are going to be as or even more significant than the internet. So we're talking about, you know, this massive change in our lives and business as well. But let's try to focus on commercial real estate. What are some of the top changes or improvements that you currently see in the CRE space when it comes to AI?
You know, when it comes to AI, and rolling back just a second, again with my age, I actually remember when somebody said, "Have you heard of this internet thing? It's going to be big."
Or email,
So,
or email.
I was right. That was right after college for me, and I actually had heard of the internet thing because it's been around for a lot longer. And I actually started off as a computer science major, so I knew what it was. But at the same time, it was still the birth and beginning of it. I think we're in that. You know, AI has been around actually for decades. It really has. I mean, a smart thermostat is technically AI. It's reading and adjusting and making figuring out how it can be more efficient. That is the definition of artificial intelligence. Without your input, making the adjustments to be able to do that. So it's been around in different forms for decades. The key is when it comes to the CRE, and a lot of people are talking about it, is how is it going to affect that? I think it's going to streamline the processes, probably more on the back end. But at the same time, you know, there's an old saying in the IT world, the best person to fix a computer isn't the one who knows the most about the computer, it's the one who knows how to Google the best. So junk in, junk out. If you're not using, even if you have AI as your tool and you're saying you're using it, but if you're not using it correctly or if you're giving it the wrong prompts, you're going to be worse off than if you didn't use it.
Prompt
So
engineering, right? There's a term for it. There's an actual term, prompt engineering. I think there could
I believe
that
so. I had heard that, but yeah, I believe so. That is, but it's so true in this day and
There's an
age. I'm
actual
just
study and there's an actual practice on communication with AI, and that's prompt engineering. But yeah, exactly. Keep going, please. Yeah, tell us about
So within the CRE industry, I see it, you know, there's always going to be a need for the art aspect. You know, what we talked about earlier, you know, everybody has all the same data. It's how you put that data together, or everybody has the same paints. It's how you put that paint together and the strokes and the brushes that you use to make it either a masterpiece or a 5-year-old's, you know, piece of art for the school. That is all about the art aspect. It's an AI doesn't necessarily have that art down yet. That's where you're starting to see things, look at things, whether it's, you know, the problem with right now, people are using the standardized prompts to figure out what's going on, as opposed to delving deeper, kind of like what we talked about a little bit earlier, where,
Well,
you
George,
know.
we appreciate the broad answer. But
Okay.
particularly, what are you seeing right now in your offices, in all of your brokers that are working with you? You talked about over 30 brokers, different asset classes, a lot of service providers that are servicing you guys. What are the changes you're seeing that AI is literally there, either a service provider or some changes you see on an everyday basis, aside from yourself jumping on ChatGPT?
Very quickly, it's a lot of it is more about the organization efficiencies of teams, where you're starting to see a lot of inputs going back and forth along those lines. We're using the databasing is really a key component on the AI side. In addition to that, where we're seeing it, and I think where I use it a lot is extrapolating data for site visits and things like that, so I can analyze the strength of the tenant. So, you know, I
Oh,
think one of the top tools that we're using is, you know, like a Placer.ai, which tracks mobile cell phone usage and how many people go to a site and how many don't.
interesting.
So
Oh,
from that,
interesting.
I can figure out what their average sales are, and then from that, I can figure out what the max rent they can pay.
Okay.
But that being said, almost everything that we've seen on the AI side has so far been on the back end, whether it's through the CRMs. We are seeing more. It's more about the efficiencies of the biz dev on the business development side, because we've invested quite a bit on the AI side in business development. We're seeing it where it's scraping data off of, like, let's say, for instance, Yelp, if you're going after businesses on the retail side, and customizing the email specifically for that and saying and referencing things that are in the Yelp reviews so
Okay,
that
so
they,
with that
it
with
making
that
it
being
more
said,
appear more personalized.